Your Highness, I've brought that thing you asked me for. The report on my run-in with your with a certain traveler.
Good. As for this traveler, please append my following words to the report.
My pen is at the ready.
After the traveler awoke in the land of Teyvat, he befriended a companion who declared themselves to be the best tour guide ever.
Ah, this sounds like the intro to an isekai light novel from Inazuma. But I doubt that tiny and scatterbrained partner is going to be of much help. If you want my opinion, she's got nothing on your former partner.
He encountered a mysterious tempest and rescued a mighty dragon that had been led astray. Gentle winds once again danced across the earth as a wandering bard sang a ballad of freedom.
Looks like these bishops are a completely different breed from those down beneath the ocean. Actually, speaking of the sea, Mondstadt's fisherman's toast, always on point.
He saw resolve as unyielding as rock, and the courage of a people united in battle against an ancient god. Now the sound of laughter rings out in the streets, and the floating pavilion in the sky will bear witness to the harbor's prosperity for generations to come.
To be fair, if I was napping on the beach and something got between me and my son, I'd go from catching rays to making waves pretty quickly too. Is that not how it went down?
He heard the whispered aspirations of a nation's people, and so challenged the embodiment of resplendent lightning. When a dream takes root in the midst of the infinite turbulence, even eternity is given a new meaning.
He picked a fight with an Archon? This guy's a beast! Well, now I don't feel so bad about those beatings I took.
He caught the scent of verdure and the fragrance of roses. And then...
Your Highness?
Let's continue another time. Sooner or later, he will make his mark on the desert.
You're not wrong, but, marks don't last very long on the desert sand.
I wonder what choices you will make, Aether.
Shall I come with you, or... guessing that's a no.